Hi everybody, I thank School Ventures for giving me this opportunity of educating people. Today we are going to dive into the topic of goal setting, but I'm going to start it on a slightly offbeat note. So what do I mean by that? Often we see that we set goals, but we actually fail to achieve it. Why does that happen? That is because it is seen by research that maximum 17 to 19 days, most of us fail in our goals. But why are we failing in our goals? Because we didn't set it right the best way. In the beginning itself, we are not setting it in the right way. So what is the right way of setting our goals? To set our goals, we first need to set the mindset for it, the preparation for even setting up a goal. For example, if I would like to travel to Shimla, wouldn't I make a lot of preparations even before I make the itinerary, reach the place and actually see a lot of places in Shimla? There are ticket bookings to be done, hotels to be done, the transport, etc. And now with COVID being there, even the RT-PCR tests being done, etc., etc., health, all this has to be taken into account before even we actually get to Shimla. So there's a lot of preparation to actually even set a goal. Similarly, for this year, I set a goal that I would be liking to read 2 books every month. I want to complete a lot of books. So what did I start doing? While I like reading, I like watching videos, sometimes reading too much also is boring. So instead, I picked up an audible book to prepare my mind to start approaching my goals. So I actually picked the book called Thinking Like a Monk by Jay Shetty. So every day I listen to the audible at least for 10 to minute, 15 minutes, if not more, so that I'm somewhere nearing my goal of reading 2 books per day. So this is the preparation I am doing to even set my goal. So friends, preparation is very, very important even before we set a goal. Otherwise, we are just likely to fail in our goals. We're just likely to forget it and say, okay, fine, that's it. And just it gets dissolved. So now, having prepared towards your goal, having set a goal, let's dive into how we set our goals smartly. You must have heard of this word smart goals many times, right? So we'll run through an example of how we are setting our goals in a smart way. So S-M-A-R-T. To start with, we have to be specific with our goal. We have often heard this. Being specific is terrific. So next, let's get into achievable goals. So how do we actually achieve our goal? Achievable and measurable actually go hand in hand. Achievable is something like if there is an athlete, let's say he is preparing for Olympic. Okay. So what is the achievable and measurable goal that they will set? Initially, the number of rounds, the running, the preparation, and all of the body flexibility, that is going to be the achievable goals. Later on, how fast they are able to run day by day. Let's say 13 seconds, the next day they level it to 11 seconds, 9 seconds. The number of meters they are able to stretch themselves up to. So measuring at every stage is very, very necessary so that we are moving slowly towards our actual goal. We are progressing day by day towards our real goal. So this is where measurable and achievable go hand in hand. So sometimes it happens that, you know, we do have some breakdowns, but you will have to realign yourself to the main goal and understand why this particular thing did not work and then rework on your strategy to reach your goal. So we covered now SMA, which is specific, measurable and achievable. Now let's go to something that is R, which is called the relevance. What is the relevance of this in your life? It must be matching with your personality and it must be matching with who you are, what you want to really achieve in your life, right? So that particular goal should be relevant to the time, to the specific activity that you want to do, and most importantly, it is something you really wish to achieve in your life. So that is what is the importance of relevance. Then it also needs to be a time-bound goal. I said, even as I began this with the example, that we are setting to achieve 95 percentile marks in maths in the month of March or in my board exams, which is happening in April or March of 2022. This is a very specific time-bound goal and I'm working backwards on that. I'm preparing well during my exams, my preparatory tests, my unit tests, etc. I'm taking my own tests to reflect on how well I'm doing right now. But friends, let me warn you here. Sometimes our time-bound goals may require a little bit of realignment due to some changes in the environment. Our environment and the people around us or the situations around us sometimes will not be supporting the actual goal that we want to really achieve. So if I say that, you know, we want to construct a house and do the house burning ceremony on a particular day because it's very auspicious for us. But nevertheless, it hardly happens that on the same day we are able to achieve it. Good that if we are able to. But due to various reasons, due to a lot of people being involved, a lot of processes being involved, that may not happen at the same time that we actually perceived. So during those situations, during some unforeseen situations or situations out of your control, you may want to rework on your goal and set a slightly different timeline. So let me see how much you can take out of this video. I hope all of you enjoyed this video. Please achieve your goals in the smart way. All the smart people out there, achieve your goals in the smart way. All the best to you. Thank you so much.
To receive such more informative videos uninterruptedly, kindly like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you all and see you soon.